Some people are miserable because every day they think that for them to be complete, they have to be married. So all that they do, everything that is driven their mind, I'm looking to be married. So they're ready to sell out themselves for nothing just to be married. The apostle Paul said, if you're single, what do you do? Don't look for a wife. It means if you single today, because there is benefit to singleness. As we continue to read that verse, we will realize that some single people will score over the married, because married people have another problem. There is somebody else they have to satisfy. Right? They better, if they want to remain married. It goes on and he said, but if you do marry, you have not sinned. And if a virgin marries, she has not sinned. But those who marry, come on, pay attention if you're ready to marry. Those who marry will face how many trouble? Many troubles in this life. Listen to me. We are at the end of this sermon series. Marriage is not a game. Marriage is complicated on its own. Marriage is difficult. Don't think that marriage will solve your problem. If you have a problem today, Jesus will solve your problem. Marriage will expose your problem. Come on, I'm giving you the truth. Yeah. If you have a problem today, Jesus will solve them, and marriage will expose them.
Yeah.
If you're a lazy woman and you marry, your name will be all over your family. Come get your daughter. She's sleeping all day long. But when you're single, who knows you're sleeping all day long? You by yourself in your house, right? Marriage will expose who you are for real. So when you have trouble right now and you're not married, don't you race to be married. Find solution in Jesus first. The Bible says, do not be unequally yoked. Don't marry outside of the family of God. Somebody says a Christian means nothing. See their faith with your very eyes. How can they be Christian and they don't go to church? They don't die. They don't do anything about God. They are not Christian. They're religious. And if you want to marry a religious, be ready for them to bite you when you really want to serve God. Now, when you ignore God in the selection, the other part is ignoring God in the way you should conduct yourself in the marriage. Because some people think that it's all about being married. No, the real trouble is keeping your marriage. Because God is the one who hates divorce. But some people, they can't take it. They will walk off you before you realize. And now you were trying that you think you were building your world around marriage. You will cry because that marriage will crumble. You have a choice when you're single. Because after that, there is no choice. Technically, according to the word of God. But the world is teaching us that there is choice because they divorce. That's why people divorce. You need to be knowledgeable and you need to apply the knowledge when it's time to select. I told the people who come yesterday, run away from two beautiful people. Somebody's too beautiful, they think that they get it all together. They will make you dance in their song alone because they're beautiful. The Bible says beauty is meaningless. Beauty is nothing. The woman who fears the Lord, she is the one who is going to be praised. I'd rather have a woman, you know, she can manage with some makeup and she's still good, than having a woman who is like a Miss World, but she cannot even hold a house together. Amen. Because it's the woman that holds a house together. So you don't have time to make a mistake choosing the wrong person and waste the rest of your life wishing and you have chosen God instead of choosing Matthew. You don't have that time to waste. Do you realize it? This life, you won't get a spare. That's your life and that's it. The day you go, that's it. You don't have time to make mistakes. I hear some people say, if it doesn't work, I'll choose somebody else. Who say you're going to have time to choose somebody else? Your life may be over in that mess. So, now that you know it, choose right. Marriage is not a possession. Some people think that marriage is something that is going to become an idol. You have married something it was never intended to be. I see some women, when they marry, now they become slaves and they forget about God. They make the marriage their idol. All that they're trying to do is please somebody, ignoring God. God has never intended for marriage to become an idol. It is just a trust. It is not a possession. So God said, listen to me. Some people marry and they had the wrong expectation. situation. They are putting an expectation that my marriage will bring me this. The person that I'm married will bring me this. Now you get into the marriage, you are disappointed because they cannot give what you thought they could give, because only God can give you what you are after. And now you are disappointed with the institution of marriage. You are disappointed with the people, but the real problem is you. You are making marriage what it was never meant to be. People, stop having unrealistic expectation of the other party. Oh, I didn't know this is how you were. Me too, I didn't know this is how you were. Before we married, this is not what I thought you will be. People of God, stop putting unnecessary pressure on people to behave and do things they have never built by God to do. Your joy is not another human being's responsibility. The Bible says, the joy of the Lord, this is what is going to be your strength. Hallelujah. Stop putting pressure on people and having unrealistic expectations. Marriage will not make you happy if you are not already happy on your own. And I'm married and I'm telling you that. And I'm happily married. But it's not my marriage that is my source of joy. God is my source of joy. I said God is my source of everything. When I need something, I reach to Him. Now if He wants to use another human being to solve that problem, let it be. But I do not put the pressure on another human being to give me what they don't have.